this is what happened in last week's video. Let us continue.
What is this?
Leonard, my cousin, just arrived. Just put the car back, and Leonard arrived. And yeah, he made a throw, I made a throw. And I have on here, which I don't know what it is. Feels like some sort of flat fish or something. My drag is a bit sticky after landing that car, because my drag was loose. Because it wasn't tight enough, and then the wave came over, and now the drag is a bit sticky, but it's okay. But I don't know what creature we have on here. Definitely not a cob, this one, but a goodie nonetheless. Always lucky to be tight. I'm just problem. Guys, I don't think I have the tackle on here for whatever this is. I'm happy with my main line, happy with the reel, and happy with the rod. But I only have like a little 100 pound leader on, and a 7.0 BKK. yeah, so I'm a bit worried about my terminal tackle. That's my only concern. But the rest is okay. I don't know what this is. It's not shaking like a raggy. It takes too much line, otherwise it's a solid raggy. I don't know what it is. But it's a big fish. My only concern is the length of my wire, the 60 pound, and the 100 pound leader. The rest is okay. And then if it's a black ray, which I don't think it is, the 0.90 hook snood at the back. money for. Guys, I'm really concerned about that 100 pound leader that I have on. Because that leader is not meant for fish like this. So I don't want to force the fish, I'm just going to take it easy. It's a lekker fish. It's coming. I really have no idea what this is. No idea, I can't tell you what it is. All that I know, it is a good fish. Basically, back almost onto my backing. Just gonna, like I said, take it easy on the fish. I don't wanna force it. The terminal tackle is quite light. One thing I can tell you guys, and even though the terminal tackle is quite light, the rod handles this fight like a champ, like an absolute champ. Tell you, I'll take on any fish with this rod. Some sort of angle on this fish, because with this light tackle, not going to be easy to just pull it. This won't be a fish that you're going to just physically pull. You need to. There you go, it's backing. Creature of the ocean we are stuck into here, and I'm not winning. I'm definitely not winning this battle at this time, but it is fun. It is a lot of fun, I promise you that. Even if I lose this fish, it is okay, but it is fun.
I win like 20 meters and then it takes another 50. So I've absolutely gained zero on this fish.
pressure. See what I spray.
Ek trek 20 en dan vat hy 50.
Well, I'm slowly gaining some line back now. But it's still quite a few couple of meters away from my backing knot. But at least I'm gaining a little bit line. I won't say that I'm winning some line. But yeah, this is a good fish, guys. Really good fish. Real patient with it. Because like I said, I don't have the terminal tackle on for this fish. So it's all about patience if you want to have the slightest chance of landing it. And here, okay, it's coming quite good now. Just keep it swimming in the same direction and we will gain some line. But my real problem is going to be getting this fish over the bank in the shallow white water, where I actually need to pull the fish. That's going to be a tough one, but baby steps. We'll take it when we get there. We'll face it when we get there. Going towards that reef. Well, gaining some meters now. And at least it's taking an angle. I don't have my drag set to maximum because I can't give too much pressure, but there's as much pressure as my terminal tackle can handle on the fish at the moment. So you don't want to do something stupid and lose it because you did something stupid. Try and stay attached to the fish as long as possible. And then you'll have a chance to land it. Okay, here's the top shot coming back. And we're just waiting for that fish to swim over the bank. I'm not going to follow it. Because then I'm going to walk and walk and walk and walk. And I don't have the tackle on to physically pull it over the lip. So I'm just holding it at an angle. And then let it swim over the lip. And when I'm talking about the lip, I'm referring to the back bank or the drop-off. So I feel quite comfortable with the fight at this stage, even though I know I'm a bit undergunned. But I do feel in some sort of that I'm a bit in control. And so I feel real good. But the problem comes in that last couple of minutes. But we'll have to wait and see and hope for the best. I'm totally confused to what I'm on here with. At times it feels like it's definitely a black ray, and then at times it definitely feels like a shark. But I'm enjoying this fight on the light tackle. really. It is really a lack of fight. Really, really enjoyable. And see what I said with the fish going left, arcing left, and as it comes back to the right, you'll gain some line. And I've probably gained like 200 meters or 150 meters. So yeah, it's going good. I did now is when the fish moved a bit to the right, I moved with it, not all the way towards it, because there's a lot of rips and a lot of current on that left hand side, and here's a little bit flatter, a flatter section, a little bit less of rip currents, and yeah, it's just gonna make it a little bit easier for me, slightly to the right. So that's why I've moved here. I'm gonna position myself here and then see if you can't get the fish in a landable position. Ooh, these dunes are soft. Just told Leonard that one thing that this fish reminds me of is kind of like a duck bill. And the fight is quite similar to a duck bill ray, but I don't know if a duck bill ray will chow in this semi-fresh water that we have here, because I've never caught them in the semi-fresh water, and but you never know, it is possible. So we've added another species to the list. And Leonard had to run because he has a bite. There is his rod bouncing. We've added another, let me just put this camera in the bush here. We've added another species to the list as what it can be, but yeah, it just feels like it is a solid fish and really enjoyable fight. But if I can see that it is a duck bill, then I know there's nothing on his body. He doesn't have a really rough body or a tail that can thrash the leader off. Then I can put a little bit more pressure on him, but I don't think I should put any more pressure than I'm already putting on. But I'm sort of kind of winning at this stage. It's coming in real nice now. And there's Leonard on. So back to me fishing, filming, doing what I love, boys, doing what I love. Okay, so bloody lekker! Come on, boy. Like I said, this is only an 8000 twin power with a 14000 spool, and this cross, and this brand new JDB Ultra Tech braid, 30 pound. And it is ridiculously thin, it feels like a 20, and it's holding up, amazing stuff, throws well. Yeah, it's just lekker. enjoying every second. Really close now. Come on, I haven't seen it. Leonard has to land his fish now so that I can decide what I'm going to do with this fish now. He'll need to grab it real, hopefully within the next 10 minutes or so. Let me get up. Guys, the fish is just behind the white water, really close, but I still haven't seen it. And yeah. Giving me carrots, eh? Guys, I actually can't believe we're in this position at the moment. The fish is right here in the white water. We still haven't seen it, but Leonard is going down to see if he can't see it and then grab it, because it's getting really close now. And it's like I said, I can't believe we're in this position at the moment. I really didn't think I'm gonna stand all the chance with this fish, and yet here we are. Leonard going down, and we're basically 95% there from landing it. That just comes to show you what a little bit of patience can do. And yeah, look at my hands from fighting. Yeah, it's been a really fun day. And doesn't matter, even if I lose this fish, it was a fun day, and I really enjoyed my fishing. But I would love to land this fish. I would really love to land it. Just want to know if it's a duckbill or is it a black ray, what's going on. Like I said, I might be a duck bomb. That was the last fish on my mind when I saw the water this morning. And even now, it doesn't look like, well, the formation and the time of the year for the duck bomb is excellent. The weather is excellent. Water might be a bit cold for the duck bomb, but it's not too cold. And it's just the color of the water. But I wasn't convinced. Since I told you guys, Leonard is going down and we have a chance of landing this fish, it has been another 15 minutes and we still haven't seen the fish. And just giving me troubles all the way. And it's coming in really nice now. We had a lucky long run again, and now it's coming again. And leaning towards a duck bill now, just by the way it's fighting. There's Leonard going real close now. Just need like a set to push that fish closer, man. Come on, come on, man. This fish is heavy. It is heavy. Come on, man. Come on, boyke. Patience, patience. Patience, Zander. You've come far enough with it. Don't stuff it up now. Don't stuff it up. Come on.
because I don't have the heaviest of terminal tackle on, so I need to fight it clever and using my angles to his disadvantage and to my advantage, because as it's swimming left, I'll go a little bit left just to get out of the current and just until I feel positive, then I will stand still and let it basically swim at the angle so that I can gain some line. And Leonard just showed some flaps there, so I think my guess was right that it is a duckbill. Alright, there. It's really close to him now. Well, the flaps that I see from here looks like a duckbill, so I guess it is a duckbill. And now it's going again. Whew. That must be a solid fish. Sure of that. I'm just gonna go down and help Leonard there. It's a bluff. Oh, luckily, there's Aaron and Stefan Oosthuizen to grab it. There we have him, finally.
Oh.
Finally got him. That's what it's about. Sure.